Antarctica, the coldest, driest, and most remote place on Earth. In the summer of 2025, this frozen continent is undergoing a quiet revolution. Massive new research stations are rising from the ice, designed not just to survive in the planet's harshest conditions, but to thrive there. These aren't the cramped, diesel-powered bases of the past. They're high-tech, renewable-powered outposts that are redefining how humans live and work at the bottom of the world. From China's cutting-edge Qinling Station to the UK's new Discovery Building at Rothera and Australia's ambitious Davis Station Renewal, these projects represent a new era of science, engineering, and sustainable exploration. Antarctica has always been extreme. Winters can plunge to minus 60 degrees Celsius, with hurricane-level winds and months of complete darkness. For decades, simply staying alive here was a challenge in itself. But today, the stakes are higher than ever. The continent is warming nearly three times faster than the global average, accelerating ice melt and driving sea levels higher. At the same time, demand for continuous, year-round scientific data is growing rapidly. Researchers need to track changes in real time, monitoring everything from climate shifts and wildlife patterns to space weather and even early warning systems for natural disasters. Building and maintaining modern facilities here, however, comes with immense challenges. Every piece of equipment must be shipped thousands of kilometers across dangerous seas. International treaties strictly regulate construction to protect Antarctica's fragile environment. That means any new base must not only withstand the elements, but also minimize its environmental impact. It's a delicate balance between advancing science and preserving one of the world's last untouched wildernesses. China's Qinling Station. On the edge of the Ross Sea, at a remote location known as Inexpressible Island, China has completed one of the most advanced Antarctic stations ever built. Qinling Station officially opened in February 2024, becoming China's fifth base on the continent. But just a year later, in March 2025, it achieved a milestone that could transform the future of polar research. For the first time, a fully integrated renewable energy system came online, capable of supplying the majority of the station's power. The system combines powerful wind turbines with a large field of solar panels, all connected to a hydrogen energy network and advanced low-temperature battery storage. Together, these technologies now provide about 60% of the station's total electricity needs. This achievement is more than just a technological breakthrough. In Antarctica, every liter of diesel fuel has to be shipped in at great cost and risk. By reducing dependence on fossil fuels, Qinling not only cuts emissions, but also simplifies logistics and lowers environmental hazards. It stands as one of the first Antarctic stations to run primarily on clean energy, setting a precedent for how future research bases could operate. Qinling is more than a place for science. It's a blueprint for sustainable living at the edge of the world. The UK's Discovery Building at Rothera. Thousands of kilometers away on Adelaide Island off the Antarctic Peninsula, the United Kingdom is reshaping one of its most important research hubs. Rothera Research Station has been a cornerstone of British Antarctic science for decades. Now, it's entering a new era with the construction of the Discovery Building. Spanning 4,500 square meters, this state-of-the-art facility brings nearly every essential function under one roof. Laboratories, workshops, offices, energy systems, water production, and storage are all integrated into a single, efficient structure. What makes the Discovery Building truly remarkable is its design. Engineers have carefully shaped it to withstand the relentless Antarctic environment. Specially crafted wind deflectors prevent snow from piling up around the building. High-performance insulation keeps heat inside, reducing carbon emissions by roughly 25% compared to older facilities. Even the corridors are fully enclosed, allowing staff to move safely between areas during storms. Inside, the design focuses on human comfort. Clever use of natural light creates a sense of space and well-being, crucial for researchers spending months in near-total isolation. The building's power and water systems are already operational, with full handover expected by the 2025 to 2026 research season. Once complete, the Discovery Building will be one of the most advanced polar research facilities in the world, setting new standards for science at the South Pole. Australia's Davis Station renewal. Further west, Australia is preparing to completely transform its Davis Station, one of three permanent Antarctic bases operated by the country. This isn't just a routine upgrade, it's a $251 million overhaul under the Antarctic Infrastructure Renewal Program. The project is vast and will unfold over 7 years, beginning in late 2025 and running through to mid-2030. The aim is to create a modern, reliable, and sustainable station that can support larger science teams for decades to come. Key upgrades include a brand new seawater intake and desalination plant, providing fresh water year-round. A new powerhouse will deliver reliable energy, while upgraded utilities and workshops will ensure safer and more efficient operations. Existing facilities will be refurbished and outdated. Inefficient buildings will be decommissioned and removed entirely. When complete, the renewed Davis Station will not just replace aging infrastructure. It will create a world-class hub for Antarctic research, capable of supporting complex missions in one of the most challenging environments on Earth. For decades, Antarctic stations followed a familiar pattern. Most were low, boxy structures that slowly became buried under drifting snow, relying entirely on diesel fuel shipped in from thousands of kilometers away. Some innovative designs tried to fight these problems. Germany's Neumayer 3 station, for example, was built on hydraulic legs, allowing it to rise above accumulating snow. Belgium's Princess Elizabeth station, completed in 2009, was the first to operate with zero emissions, powered entirely by wind and solar energy. Today's new stations are taking these ideas further. Modern buildings are elevated and aerodynamic, designed to resist snowdrifts rather than be consumed by them. Renewable energy systems are now standard, combining wind, solar, hydrogen, and advanced battery storage. It's a clear shift from the old model of survival-driven outposts to modern sustainable hubs that can support cutting-edge science while protecting the environment they study. Across the continent, several trends are shaping the future of Antarctic construction. Hybrid clean energy systems are becoming the norm, blending wind, solar, hydrogen, and batteries to drastically cut diesel use. Older stations are being retrofitted with better insulation and upgraded systems to lower emissions. Prefabricated building modules are now common, allowing crews to assemble complex structures quickly during the short summer construction season. Snow management has evolved into a science of its own, with elevated platforms, aerodynamic building shapes, and even wind deflectors engineered to keep snow from accumulating around key areas. Behind the scenes, smart monitoring systems track everything from energy consumption to structural health, allowing teams to anticipate maintenance needs and prevent failures before they happen. These advances aren't just about making life more comfortable. They ensure that research can continue year-round, uninterrupted, in one of the harshest climates on the planet. The transformation of Antarctica is far from over. Several nations are already planning the next generation of research stations. Poland is constructing a completely new building for its Arctowski station, raised 3 meters above the snow and built with prefabricated components for quick assembly. It's expected to be completed by mid-2026. India is preparing to replace its aging Maitri base with a new, modern facility known as Maitri 2. Turkey is moving forward with plans for its first permanent Antarctic station, marking a major milestone for its research program. New Zealand also has redevelopment plans underway as nations around the world recognize the need to modernize their presence on the continent. This wave of investment reflects a global commitment to both scientific discovery and environmental protection. Antarctica has always been a place that pushes human limits. For decades, the challenge was simply surviving here. But in 2025, the mission has changed. Now it's about building smarter, cleaner, and more sustainable ways to study this vital region. From China's renewable-powered Qinling Station to the UK's innovative Discovery Building and Australia's bold Davis Station renewal, these projects are reshaping what life at the bottom of the world looks like. The question now is simple. If you had to spend a season in Antarctica, where would you choose to live and work? Qinling's clean energy systems, Discovery's modern design, or Davis Station's ambitious new facilities? As construction continues and more nations join the effort, one thing is certain. The future of Antarctic research is no longer just about survival. It's about thriving, and doing so in a way that protects the last great wilderness on Earth.